on, man? What's going on? I thought we were talking. Let's talk. Let's talk. Why'd your wife leave you?
Syd, it's not a pleasant scene for me, please.
Oh, my scene's pleasant?
Mate, I've been 21 before. I know your pain. But where you're trying to push me right now is not a place you want to go.
Wait a minute. Are you trying to say that since you're older than me, your pain is somehow more?
Unfortunately, that's the case.
Listen. First of all, you don't have the slightest fucking clue what pain I've been through, all right? Just since you've been on this earth a couple decades more does not mean your pain is any more or less than mine. I'm sorry, I wish it did, but it doesn't. Secondly, don't make blind comparisons when you have no fucking clue what you're comparing, all right?
You think having your heart broken is pain? You think losing God is pain? Mate, I went through that trivial shit when I was 20. I'm 40 now, mate. Where you're trying to push me right now is not a place you want to go. So why don't you do yourself a favor and don't fucking go there with me? You're a fucking child. You're just a kid.
A kid? Listen, you pompous, limey fuck. If you had one-tenth my pain, you'd be psychologically fucking crippled.
Mate, seriously, fuck off. Look, all we're doing is projecting shit here. Look, take a step back. Let's relax, shall we? Do a bit of gear, have a line.
Come on. Fuck the gear. I don't want that shit. Get it away from me.
Good, more for me.
It's Bateman, right?
Pleased to see your memory's still intact.
Well, Bateman, let me give you a little glimpse into my life, a little insight into my personal fucking pain.
Mate, it's not necessary, truly.
No, it is necessary, and if you didn't think it was necessary, you wouldn't have gone there. You wouldn't have pushed my fucking buttons, but you did. If you don't want to hear it, you should stop snorting my shit and get the fuck out of the bathroom.
Well, technically it's my shit, but I can see you're passionate, so go.
So this fucking guy out in LA, who my chick is now in love with, he's, you know, endowed.
She told you that.
Yeah, so anyway, I needed to know how big. Not that I give a fuck about another guy's dick or anything. I just wanted to know. It's one of those things you feel like you need to know. So we're in an argument, and I keep pushing her. I was pushing her, and I was like, how big is he? You know, how big is he? And she was like, let's not make an issue out of it, Syd. And I said, no, fuck that. Tell me how big he is. And she says, 10.5 inches.
Jesus.
Yeah, you believe that shit?
She could have at least rounded it down. Look, the girl's trying to hurt you, mate.
Yeah, no shit. But it really fucked with me, you know? It fucked with my head, knowing that this guy is in LA with the only woman I love, fucking her with 10.5 inches. I'm chasing her around like a little fucking puppy dog, doing everything and anything I can to get her back. And it crushed me. It still fucking crushes me.
Sorry, mate. How exactly do you deal with that?
You don't deal with it. It deals with you. We'd get in these fights and I'd say the most horrible things. I'd be like, you just want a fat cock and your fat snatch, you fucking whore, you know? I'd just mean horrible things. I'd be so fucking angry, you know?
I used to say the same shit, mate. I used to say the most horrendous shit.
Why, what'd she do?
She didn't really do anything. You know, I imagine a lot of it had to do with me and to do with my hang-ups and depression and shit, but, my God, I should say the worst shit to her. I tormented that girl. I lived with her for 3.5 fucking years, and I hated her.
So what was the final snap? What happened? Did you cheat on her? She cheat on you?
No, God, no.
Yeah, but how do you know?
Because I didn't, you know? I didn't.
I know you didn't. How do you know she didn't cheat on you?
I know she didn't. It wasn't her thing.
How do you know?
Listen, I was with the most beautiful girl in the universe. She'd fuck me for 2 fucking years.
Why?
I don't know. Because we fought. I was in therapy. I don't know. If you want to know what it is, I'll tell you what it is. You remember sentences that people say to you, you know, sentences that stick in your mind like gunshot wounds that never fucking heal. I remember my ex-wife said to me, this is when we first started dating, she said, you know, I love it when a guy fucks me 4-5 times a night.
4-5 times a night?
Yeah.
Come on.
I was like, he was with some guy who fucked you 4-5 times a night? You wanna know what pain is?
What?
I'll tell you what pain is, you fuck.
Why are you calling me a fuck?
Because, my friend, you fuck, you brought me here, and I didn't particularly want to go here, but now I am. So if you don't want to go where I'm about to go, then you better tell me right now, and I'll walk out the fucking door, I'll phone my therapist, and that will be it, okay? End of story.
No, fuck that. I want to hear this. You're not going anywhere.
You want to know what it is?
Yes, I want to know what it is. Did we go over this?
Motherfucker, you want to know what it is?
Yes.
Pain, my friend, is when the woman you love wants to fuck you 4 or 5 times a night and you can't.
Why?
Why? Why? I'll tell you why. Because I'm an impotent man, motherfucker. That's pain. That's fucking pain. When your wife wants to fuck you 4 times a night and you fucking can't. You know that some fucker before you could, and you know that some fucker after you will. Well, I couldn't cope with that, could I? That sense of ruination, that insolvency that burns in your soul. I couldn't fuck my wife. Do you know what that fucking means, mate? Do you understand what impotent rage really is?
I'm sorry.
You have no fucking idea, mate.
I'm sorry, Ed.
Oh, you're sorry? Oh, you're sorry, are you? You dare. You dare. You fucking dare ask me if there's a God? Well, man, I feel forsaken. I feel cheated, you cunt. I've lost in the big game. And nothing else fucking matters. It doesn't matter what you do. If you can't hack it in the sack, mate, if you can't hack it in the game of love and sex, you are shit, my friend. Because you can't do what the other man can do to your fucking wife, mate.
I know what you mean. It's...
No, motherfucker! You do not know what I mean! You could possibly know what the fuck I mean! I failed. Fucking fail, mate. And I'm still failing every fucking day of my life. Every day. Every fucking day.
Sorry, excuse me.
What?
Sorry. London, are you okay?
Yeah. We're just gonna go. We're gonna go and talk.
Yeah? Because if you want, I'll call security and have them taken out. I've got no problem with that.
Becca, can you do me a favor? Can you stay out of this, please?
You've been doing cocaine in my parents' bathroom all night. So don't fucking tell me what I can and cannot do in my own fucking house, considering you weren't even invited.
It's cool. Beck, we're just gonna go.
No,
we're gonna leave. It's gonna be
cool.
Fine.
It's not cool, London. Baby, he wasn't invited. You didn't want him here. I didn't want him here. No one wants him
Look,
here.
Look, Becca, can you just relax, please?
Tell me to relax.
Why? Why can't you relax for 2 fucking seconds? We're leaving.
You're shouting for starters in my fucking party. And also, you're a psychotic. You couldn't take a fucking hint if it smashed you in the face. She doesn't want to be with you. She doesn't want to spend even 20 seconds
We're leaving. Let's
with
go.
You.
So, Becca, I'm sorry.
You know what? I'm sorry, London, and I'm not trying to be a bitch here. But when you come back here, you come back alone. I don't want you in my house again, all right? Or I will call the fucking cops.
Sorry. I'm really trying to be calm here, all right?
Fuck off. I'm so tired of you and your psycho fucking shit.
You want to talk about psycho shit? Let's talk about your fucked up life. Because we can talk about that right now.
Fuck you.
No, fuck this. You want to fuck with me?
You weren't even invited to this party.
Go home.
You want to fuck with me, Becca? You
stop it, this is your job. Go home.
Get the fuck out of here. How many times did you fuck your freshman year? What was it, 15, 20? I think I lost count. Was it the whole fucking pledge class?
Sorry.
Isn't that funny, Jay? You never really know your girlfriend. Isn't that a total mind fuck?